Hello and welcome to Let's Talk Sports preview of Manchester United.
You nearly said the C word.
Manchester United versus Young Boys taking place in the Champions League this coming Tuesday at Old Trafford. And well, it could be a key game really for United, because if we were to lose it, it opens the door for Valencia in the group. And, you know, could be a contesting last game in the group for both teams, really. But we'll have to wait and see how the result from this game opens it up or not, because it is United's hands at the moment in their group, after a good win against Juventus last time out, 2-1, away from home as well.
Should not have happened.
Some may have called it a little bit lucky in that sense, but overall, a win's a win, and they can take what they want from it. But since then, it's been a bit of a shaky trip for them, 0-0 against Crystal Palace at the weekend. Looking at the likes of Lukaku to really step up, is this a game that he needs to step up in and get some goals in?
So I think not just because of the fixture, but for himself, you know, he's got to prove that he's going to have a future at Man United, because we're not seeing it. And Old Trafford, with it being at Old Trafford, it's a place that he doesn't like at the moment. I think it was 200...
He hasn't scored since March.
That just says it all, doesn't it?
14 hours, I think, or something like that.
That's ridiculous. I mean, you know, it says it all. And I think for the Champions League, United have it in their control now. You know, they should be going through. So this is a must win, no matter if the Lukaku performs or not. Because, you know, the young boys, as they are showing, they're a bit inexperienced. They're not always used to playing in the Champions League. Well, they never played in the Champions League before.
No, it's the first season in the Champions League.
So, they've had a good go. They'd like to get a result at Old Trafford, but they are against confused boys at the moment, you could say, because we don't know who our starting 11 is. We don't know who's going to provide the goals for us, if not the Lukaku. So, at the moment, the young boys, they may look at this and think, OK, on paper, we're not going to win this fixture, but they could certainly give it a good go. I've said it before, and I said it again on our videos, Old Trafford is not a fortress anymore. No one is scared to go there and get a result. So I'm a bit concerned. The win against Juventus was a bonus, because I thought it'd be these last two games we'd have to win them to get that second place. You never know. If we win our last two games and Juventus bottle it up again in their other matches, we might win the group.
You never know. You never know. We'll talk about potential starting lineups in a sec, because you briefly mentioned that. I just want to talk about De Gea, though. Recently, some rumours have popped up in saying that potentially he could leave. There've always been rumours saying that he could leave, but it seems as though a newcomer has come into the frame now. It's not Real Madrid, it's PSG. Now, the PSG, of course, cash giants, looking like a team that could potentially challenge for the Champions League in future years with Kylian Mbappe and Neymar up front as well.
How could you replace Buffon?
How important, though, is De Gea for United moving forward?
He is our saviour. You know, he's been our player of the season at least 3 years in a row now. Tell me another club that's had that, you know, a goalkeeper being your main man in the last 3 or 4 years. I don't know where to start. Maybe Buffon for Juventus, but it's, you know, this is ridiculous. But, you know, I think what's really important is that De Gea's had a haircut. So times are changing for him as well. You know, he doesn't like his old haircuts. And, you know, what really annoys me is that I bought a PSG ticket. Now, that means some of my euros has gone into that investment of De Gea, if that does happen.
I have essentially
bought De Gea.
You've essentially helped PSG buy De Gea and ruin your football club.
Exactly.
So well done to you.
Thank you. And I am publicly shamed. But no, I'm worried. And I think if we carry on playing this way, does he really have a reason to stay?
If you were to get knocked out of the Champions League, do you think that could be it for De Gea at United?
As in the group stages or in I mean, we're not going to win the Champions League, so there's no point even discussing that. I mean, I don't know what to think. I mean, if De Gea's got pride, he'd stay. But if he wants to, you know, De Gea is like the equivalent of Harry Kane up front. You can't waste that career, because you're going to look back and think, I could have won the Champions League at Madrid. He could have gone to Madrid on a number of occasions. And this is when I look at Harry Kane the same way. They're doing great for their clubs, but they know they're better than those teams at the moment. And sadly for De Gea, if you are somehow watching this, go. you know, I mean, just as a careers advice, just go, because you're not getting anything in that United team.
No, and there certainly wouldn't be any malice from any United fans if he was to leave at this point.
You'll get Player of the Season awards all the time, but that's it.
So what other starting lineups would you like to see for United? Who are the other 10 players that you want to see on the pitch on against Young Boys?
Well, I mean, I want Lukaku to start because he needs to get himself going again. He does not deserve to rest or be on the bench. He needs to prove himself. Sanchez is another one for me. Can he prove himself? I think he's had enough chances. I think he should be gone in January. I don't care where he goes, he's useless. But you know, I always like to see United start Mata. If this was a bigger game, I would start Mata in any match, which, you know, I look back at the Man City game and think, why didn't he start? And then we had instead Matic, Herrera and Fellaini in midfield, which is just there's no creativity there whatsoever. Look, I think a normal squad will do. We just got to make sure we pick up the 3 points. If we don't get a result, then the Valencia game away is going to be a lot more difficult than expected.
Yeah, just a brief mention on Young Boys, because they are United's opponents in this game, just in case you didn't know.
Oh, I didn't know that.
1-0 win at the weekend against Lugano in the Swiss League, and then their most recent Champions League result was a 3-1 loss away at Valencia. So this is a must-win game for them, because they technically can still make it out of the groups, but they have to win out, and they're facing against United and Juventus. So it's a bit...
If we could beat Juventus, they could beat Juventus.
So how do you think this game's going to unfold? What do you think the scoreline is going to be in this one?
Well, I'm going to say 1-0 Man U, because we can't... I've said this from the start of the season. Now people are listening. We can't score goals. We can't score team goals. We'll score from maybe a penalty or a set piece in this match. Nothing special.
No.
Difficult, I'm done.
Difficult. I think it's going to be 3-0. Last time they played, it was 3-0.
I think
United will bounce back, because, you know, they'll have to put themselves into shape after that Palace draw.
If that's a 3-0 win, we might beat Juventus on goal difference.
Potentially.
Of that. You never know.
So, what are your own predictions for the game itself? Let us know in the comment section below this video. Don't forget to like it, subscribe for more Let's Talk Sport content. See you all very soon.